Thank you, Mr. Chairman. It's also my great pleasure, really, to welcome you all to the Arab Fund and to this 25th anniversary annual conference, which marks a very special occasion for the ERF. I will start first by setting the scene, which is basically that starting from last year, that was marked by tremendous socio-economic, political, and climate changes in the ERF region, as we all know. ERF continues to respond through extensive research efforts to address these challenges, to mobilize strategic partnership, funding, and resources, and to reach out to relevant stakeholders to cope with these changes. In addition to the mainstream development challenges that we have been researching and disseminating for the last 25 years. Unfortunately for our region, an urgent emerging concern now is conflicts, governance, and post-conflict economic issues in war-affected Arab countries. So in search for answers and with generous support from Ford Foundation and IDRC, ERF launched a multi-year research program to address key issues of pertinence to these new challenges. ERF achievements in 2018 can be quickly summarized along few milestones and products. In 2018, ERF continued to play a leading role in generating and sharing research for economic development and prosperity. ERF managed in this context a total of 89 projects involving 114 researchers and published an impressive total of 110 new working papers, allowing the network now to reach 1,110 working papers, which is, I think, is a very significant achievements for the ERF. Last year, we also have 15 policy briefs and perspectives, coordinated the work towards 4 edited volumes to be published by Oxford University Press, which will be presented briefly at the last session in the third day. And published more than 100 policy articles on ERF policy portal, the forum. This is the new vehicle for reaching out to the policy community. And we hope that we will be actually strengthening and expanding this vehicle to enhance our policy relevance and policy impact. Simultaneously, ERF held 13 highly successful seminars, workshops, and conferences in 2018. Bringing together more than 500 participants from the ERF extensive network of affiliates, research and policymakers, community members, and concerned stakeholders and media. Among these events, ERF partnered with the Department of Statistics in Jordan and the Economic Social Council for the organization of a policy conference on employment, education, and housing in Jordan. The impact of Syrian refugees on the Jordanian labor market. On the data front, ERF completed the fourth round of the Egypt labor market panel survey in 2018 in collaboration with the Central Agency for Public Mobilization and Statistics, better known as CAPMAS in Egypt. For many years, the rich longitudinal and public available data of the Egypt Labor Market Panel Survey has been the workhorse of labor market and gender research in Egypt. And this is also, of course, replicated, has been replicated in Tunisia and Jordan, and hopefully in Sudan next year or later this year. We would like to welcome, actually, our colleagues from the National Statistics Centers from 13 Arab countries who will be participating in this conference and celebrating the joint efforts of building the database, the OMADI database, the open access microdata, and we will have a special session organized with the representatives of the statistics centers from these 13 countries. In 2018, the Arab Fund and the World Bank extended further support for the Arab Spring Development Initiative, the second phase of the Arab Spring Development Initiative. The multi-year partnership between the Arab Fund for Economic and Social Development and the World Bank have proven to be very important instruments for promoting ideas and also making projects happen through funding, has been a significant achievement for the past few years. And also it has been a benchmark for other donors that have also contributed to the ERF. New fundings from IDRC, UN Women, AFD, the Agence Française de Développement, and International Labour Market Organization marked the initiation of new partnership, new programs, and new thematic areas of work for the ERF. The ERF have also started operation in a branch office in Dubai to support the main operation in Cairo, and it has opened opportunities for us to initiate new projects and facilitating the expansion of existing projects, as well as to establish a presence in the GCC region, as well as to build links with universities and research and policy institutions in order to enhance the participation of GCC researchers in the ERF. ERF is looking to the future now that we are celebrating our 25th anniversary. ERF will be articulating its role and research agenda around knowledge, research networks, and development policy, a vision for tomorrow. The ERF management and network are committed to supporting new initiatives, new modalities, new partnerships to embrace change and contribute to our region's prosperity. Yesterday, we had a brainstorming meeting with a representative from our research community to discuss future research issues and themes, as well as to enhance the existing research themes by addressing new emerging issues that are deemed important for the development of the region. And we will be dedicating a plenary session at this conference in order to share the ideas and to get feedback from the participants on the future direction of the research of the ERF. I would like to take this opportunity to also express our gratitude and appreciation to the wisdom and guidance of our Board of Trustees, the generosity and support of our partners, and the commitment of our network affiliates and dedication of the staff. Together, I'm certain we are well positioned to serve our region for another most successful 25th years and beyond. I would like also to say that this conference marked also another important milestone in the history of the ERF, because we have moved as a result of a discussion that was initiated a few years ago at the General Assembly of the Research Fellows and discussed at the advisory committee and then finally approved by the board, is to move from a predetermined themes for competitive research into an open process for an opportunity, providing an opportunity for researchers to submit proposals in a broad range of issues that are deemed important for the development policy of the region. And that allowed us actually to generate a wealth of information about what are the issues that our researchers think about, have been thinking about, so much so that we actually now in this conference we will be having 15 groups as compared to the earlier six groups. And these 15 groups covered issues that have not been discussed before, or at least have not been emphasized, such as, for example, subsidies and the economics of subsidies, such as, for example, conflict and transition from war to peace, such as development strategies, in addition to the mainstream issues that has been the workhorse of our research. In this context, we were able to provide an opportunities and to consider 220 proposals, which is a very substantial increase in the number of proposals submitted. And we were able to consider 21 parallel session for 63 proposals that are accepted out of the 220 submissions, a total of 35 research fellows and researchers have actually contributed to the review. So this could not have been done without the commitment and support of our research fellows. And it has actually made a major shift in terms of the capacity of using the research fellows' support in order to make participatory research management possible through the involvement of these reviewing teams. We are able to support this number of papers, 62 papers, and we're also able to make some very good progress. We still need to do more progress, but I'm very happy to share with you that out of the 62 papers, 25 are authored by female economists. So in terms of gender, about 40% of the participants and researchers are female women, and we will continue to stress this drive, as well as to ensure that we also not leave the issue of the uneven regional distribution of the research, because we have made some progress, but we need to do more. We look forward to an active participation of all researchers in terms of the various themes that will be considered in the parallel session. And of course, we have an ensemble of very interesting open sessions, some of which, of course, are the substantive regular plenaries. But we also have special sessions aimed at providing an opportunity for the representatives of the network to share their experiences, as well as to discuss the future of the research, and to celebrate actually the ERF and what has achieved, as well as to aspire for the future. Thank you very much.